All right, time for the Willie Waffle movie reviews. Couple of big movies out this week. First time for Peanuts in 3D, and James Bond is back in Spectre.
Oh, dear God, are we saying goodbye to James Bond?
This is it. This is the last one, because if he ever has to make another one, he'll slit his wrists.
Well, at least it's goodbye to Daniel Craig. they've have this track record of replacing the guy who gets tired of the role.
All right, that's true. So is it a good send-off for Daniel Craig?
Boy, it does feel like a send-off for Daniel Craig in every way. I mean, when you see the movie, you'll see what I mean. You know, it feels like they're tying up everything that happened in all of the James Bond movies that star Daniel Craig, and they're giving him a goodbye. And it starts off with just James Bond being James Bond. He's on a rogue mission to Mexico. He hasn't been given permission. He's just chasing after a secret terrorist organization that has a sinister secret.
Now, hasn't he kind of done that in every single movie? He's kind of gone off without permission?
Oh, yeah, that's pretty much what he does. And then the boss goes, oh, you were right. But, you know, with Spectre, it just feels like something's missing. Like, I sat there thinking, did I miss 10 minutes of the movie? Did they leave something out? I mean, you know, we're making our move towards this big reveal, but it's so clouded in mystery, and I think intentionally so, that it should have much more of an impact when the big reveal happens. The problem is, you know, we already kind of heard the rumor about what the big reveal was, so it's not that shocking.
Don't tell me. I don't know what the big reveal is or the rumors
I will not
are.
Tell you.
Okay.
But I will tell you that, you know, Spectre kind of continues down that path that we saw James Bond going in Skyfall towards the end, where we're almost getting this reimagining of James Bond. You know, we're almost getting kind of the Star Trek version of James Bond, where we're revisiting characters, we're making allusions to past stories and to past behaviors, and I think that's kind of fun for the fans. I think, you know, people who aren't familiar with all the movies will kind of wonder what's the big deal. But it's still Daniel Craig. He's still the second best Bond. I'm going to go 3 waffles for Spectre.
Wow. Now, does this movie tie in at all to the previous Spectre in a James Bond movie?
Well, I can't say anything along those lines.
Oh, okay. That's the big reveal.
That's the answer right there is yes.
Okay, got it.
Okay, maybe it's not as much of a secret as I thought, okay?
Got it. All right. So our other big movie then is for people who have kids and can't see James Bond with the kids. This is the first Peanuts extra long movie, right? That made for movie theaters.
No, they had a couple, like back in the 70s. There were a couple of big screen adventures. This is the first time you'll ever see them in 3D, which is kind of cool.
Oh my gosh, I bet Snoopy's nose is huge.
It's massive. It's massive. And, you know, that's about the only tip of the hat to being modern that we get, and I think thank you for that. Because if they had Lucy twerking with a cell phone, I would have just ran out of the theater. That just wouldn't have been cool.
Do you think this movie's going to be number one?
No, it's going to be James Bond.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, I bet all these kids are loving it.
Oh, I think the kids are loving it. I think the parents are loving it, because a lot of those elements that you found in the other Peanuts movies are still here, you know? You still have the music that you remember. You still have that idea that they're in their own little world that isn't touched by the modern world. You know, we don't have cell phones. We don't have anything crazy going on. We're just getting Charlie Brown the way we've always known him. And, you know, the story is a very lighthearted story. It turns out he has a crush on the new girl who moved in next door, the little red-haired girl.
Wait a minute, I've heard this story before.
Yes, you have.
I like the little red-headed girl.
Charlie Brown doesn't know what to do because he's a guy.
Yeah. So let me guess, this is what he says to her. Wah, 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 wah.
He would have to have the courage to talk to her to get that far.
Oh, geez.
Yeah. So, you know, it's kind of innocent and frightening all at the same time, because, you know, this is one of the, I always argue this, you know, the Peanuts, everybody talks about, you know, the Pixar movies. Oh, they're for adults and kids, and there's stuff that adults like, and there's stuff that kids could like. Well, the Peanuts were doing that decades ago. You know, there was always another level to the Peanuts that the adults got that the kids didn't, but the kids enjoyed all the goofiness. And you get a lot of that here. So I'm going to say 3 waffles for the Peanuts movie.
Wow, that's pretty good. Now, is it worth the extra money to see it in 3D?
Well, those Sup with Camel moments are pretty cool.
All right. And
so maybe.
That's not a good sell, Willie. I just have to tell you, you need to work on selling that.
Well, because that's the only thing that really, I think, I think that's the only thing that works in this movie as far as 3D goes. The rest of it is just the Peanuts doing Peanut stuff.
Now, this movie has been, or these guys have been around for what, 60 years on TV?
Gosh, and something like that, yeah.
So as they've, you know, time has gone by, the kids have grown up, you know, as far as the voices and the people that played the movie characters, how close are the people that are playing the characters still sounding to some of the originals?
Yeah, I'm amazed that they always get kids who sound pretty close. I mean, it's never going to be exactly like the voices that you saw in the Christmas special or anything like that, but they're always pretty close. It's not enough to be jarring. It's not enough to make you go, that's not really Pigpen.
All right. What do we have next week?
Next week we have Love the Coopers.
Oh, I can't wait for this movie.
Well, I'm glad you're the one.
Good. I am. I'm so excited.
I can't
excited.
Wait either. I love this.
I hope it's better than The Family Stone, because that one was kind of depressing.
What? The Family Stone was an awesome movie.
I like it, but I said I want this to be better.
But here's the problem with Love the Coopers. You know, how many movies are we going to have where everybody gets together for the holidays and their family's all screwed up? I mean, you could save $10 and just wait for Thanksgiving.
You know, that is a good point. But some of us don't like spending time with our families and doing that. So now we can watch it on a movie screen.
You know, if you're running away from that, why do you want to see it on the big screen?
Because it makes you feel better to know you're not alone in the chaos.
Okay.
All right. We'll talk to you next week.
All right. Talk to you next week.